Morning, everyone. This is Friday Facts and Fun for March 19th, 2021. So today we want to talk about library programs. Since things are getting back to the usual, kind of our norm, we did have our spring break camps this last week. We had a dinosaur egg event on Monday. On Tuesday, we made Oceans in a Bottle, and on Wednesday, we had a visit from a former docent, Diego Gonzalez, and his snake, Alistair. And we had, I want to say between 12 and 15 children for most of the programs. We could only have 10 at a time, so we had the program twice. We had it at 1 and at 2:30, and I think everyone had a good time. There was at least one picture in the paper this week, and hopefully will be a couple more next. Because of the times of the events, they couldn't get them all in last week. And those were successful, and we are happy that we are back doing programming. So we are going full steam ahead planning our National Library Week programs. National Library Week this year will be April 4th through the 10th. And normally we hold programs 4 evenings during that week so people can come in and explore the library and learn a little more about what we do. We usually have a Lego night, an ice cream night, possibly a movie, and a couple of other events. So we wanted to kind of maintain that same thing, but because of the limits on the numbers we can have in the library still, we are moving most of our events outside. We will be over in Memorial Square on Monday, April the 5th. We're going to do a Lego night, but again, because of social distancing, we're going to be limited to 12 families. We're going to have tables set up with Legos, and the families can build whatever they want to build. We're going to take pictures of your creations, and then you can take them home with you. That will help with keeping things sanitized and people not touching things that other people have touched. On Tuesday, our event will be a drive-through event in front of the library, and we're going to give out a bag to each family with information about the library and our programs. And we hope to have all our summer reading finalized by then to give you information about that, but about ebooks and all the other things, our Dial-A-Story program and other things that maybe you don't know about. So we can give a bag of information, but then we're going to give out ice cream. This will be a drive-through ice cream social. And I'm still working on popsicles or ice cream sandwiches or what, but believe me, it will be ice cream. On Wednesday, we are going to have a stage set up in Memorial Square, big 6-foot circles. Each family can sit in one circle so that, again, we're socially distanced, but you can come watch the program. I have a call into magician. If that doesn't work out, we have possible storyteller or an animal program. I'll just go down my list and we will have a program. It will be fun. On Thursday, we are going to have an author event. We had several programs booked before the pandemic hit for authors come and tell us about their books. Well, we're going to combine that all up and have one big program. I have a couple of authors, historical fiction, women's fiction. I have one nonfiction author who writes about lots about plants. A to Z about weeds, A to Z about, I can't remember the other title at the moment, but all about plants. I have one author who has written a book of poetry. I have a couple of calls in for authors for teen and young adult books so that we should have all age groups. Again, the table will be in the middle. The speakers will speak about 10 to 15 minutes about their book or their writing process, or something else that they think we might find interesting about books and writing. And then each of them will have a table spread out around the park, so you can go up and buy the books and get them autographed and hopefully this will be a lot of fun. Let everybody be able to come out and enjoy it. Again, we'll have 6-foot circles where you can sit each family in one circle and keep our spacing. We are still going to require our mask because in case when you're walking in and out, you happen to walk close to someone, this will protect both you and them. So we're really looking forward to this. We hope you guys are. Watch for more information here on our Facebook page. There'll be some ads in the newspaper and flyers up around town, but hopefully we all get to do some fun stuff again. See you next week.